Sports science is a fantastic career to kind of get into, because what it allows you to do is work with individuals to try and make them try to maximize their performance as best you possibly can by applying scientific principles to their training and their nutrition to try and get the best out of them. So it relies less on anecdotal experience and more on a scientific foundation to help improve their performance.
I really wanted to work in the sporting industry, and specifically women's football, and I was really interested in the S&C side of things, so I did some research online, and Solent offered the best kind of course for getting into that. They, the accreditation, the basis accreditation, the course runs alongside it, so we learn all the content, and then at the end we're able to take the exam for the qualification efficiently.
I think the unique selling point of the course at Solent University is the fact that it's so applied and hands-on in terms of the work that students get to do. Obviously there's a theoretical underpinning to what we do, but we know that employers are really after those kind of hands-on skills. So when a graduate comes through a degree at Solent University, they not only have the underpinning theory, but they have the practical skills that they would be able to demonstrate in psychology, physiology or biomechanics, so they can transition into employment far more easily.
We've got three different support tools. One of them is a performance tool for basketball, the other is a multi-sports gym. We've got a high performance academy gym, and then the more elite end, we've got the physiology lab and biomechanics lab. In there we've got everything from altitude simulators, heat tents, to metabolic carts, body composition analyzers, blood analyzers, 3D motion capture systems, integrated force plates, portable force plates. So we've got a vast amount of equipment all available to students to use on and off campus.
The practicals are very, very hands-on. So most of the modules will have a practical element to them, whereby there is an expectation that all students get involved, because it's all well and good being able to describe what a certain activity is like. If you've never actually been involved in it and never experienced it, it's very difficult to then communicate that to someone you might well be working with later on.
So there's lots of additional courses you can take. There's help, lots of support, one-to-one stuff. They offer obviously a placement year, which is quite exciting and quite a big opportunity. And lots of work experience if you want it. You can help out in the laboratories and in the teaching gyms.
When we have external organisations come in, so we've had some local professional football teams in here doing their kind of pre-season testing, series of triathletes, distance runners in, we always make sure that we try and get as many students involved as we can, so that it's not a kind of a closed door policy where they look through the door to see what's going on. We actually try and get them involved, supporting staff while we kind of collect the data, so they start to develop that kind of real world experience, so that when they come to run it themselves, they're far more familiar with the environment.
We tend to focus on allowing students to use anything and everything the university has to offer. Nothing is kept from them, nothing is preserved for research or just academics. Anything we use on elite clubs is available for students to use on their own clients.
What's one of the unique things about sports science is that it opens up a whole kind of spectrum, from the sports performance end of the spectrum all the way down to the clinical end of the spectrum. And a lot of the skills that they will develop can be kind of transitioned basically to anyone on that spectrum. So if you're dealing with patients with certain pathologies, or if you're dealing with people who just want to get fitter, or the unique performance end, then you can look to go into roles as sports scientists, strength and conditioning coaches, performance analysts, clinical exercise scientists. It really does open up a lot of opportunities for you.